technology has come a long way. You can carry a small device that can compute a million times every second. This has created many ways to connect with each other. One of them is cryptocurrency. On January 9th, 2009, Bitcoin was created and is considered the world's first established cryptocurrency. It uses its own public database called blockchain to record transactions. That means that you can view every transaction ever made, which makes using Bitcoin secure. With that said, Bitcoin has been used in different transactions as an alternative to using banks. Not only that, it has pushed the ball rolling for what would be called cryptocurrencies. This is Satoshi Nakamoto. Well, we don't really have a photo of them. That is because it is only the pseudonym of the person who created Bitcoin. However, up until now, it is still a mystery who is the real person behind that pseudonym. And this is the Bitcoin Genesis block where cryptocurrency started. The Genesis block was simply the first Bitcoin block to be mined. It is also known as Block 0 or Block 1.
The Banco Central admits it is handling the emergence of cryptocurrency, sometimes dubbed as the money of the future, with caution.
The Philippine Senate tackles digital assets and online transactions in a briefing with the country's central bank. And
they see a lot of potential in the market, and they see a lot of growth in our market here in the Philippines. So we also have one of the clearest regulations in the world from our central bank for virtual asset service.
At the time of this creation, the price of a Bitcoin has reached from $0.0008 to approximately $29,000. That is roughly from 0.043 Philippine peso to more than 1.5 million Philippine peso. Moreover, cryptocurrencies have reached more than $1 trillion at its peak in terms of market cap value. And starting from Bitcoin, we now have more than 23,000 different cryptocurrencies. Ethereum and BNB are two of the main coins that utilize code to create usable applications. While they both have different technologies, Bitcoin, Ethereum, and BNB all use the same blockchain system. All those types of cryptocurrency and others that are too many to mention are virtual currencies that allow individuals to send currencies through digital computers, which uses a peer-to-peer system to connect to the blockchain. This means that a blockchain network would be deemed to be active unless every device that accesses it goes down. According to a study conducted by Dr. Kishor Pivolane, an associate professor in commerce, the common pros that you can get in investing in cryptocurrency are 1. Cryptocurrency networks are inherently secure. 2. Price fluctuations can create huge profits. 3. Cryptocurrency behaves like real currency. 4. Crypto transactions are generally cheaper than traditional electronic financial transactions. And 5. Cryptocurrency can reduce the cost of international transactions. To find a way to send money over the internet, Bitcoin was created. It was intended for Bitcoin to provide an alternative payment system that removes control from something like a financial institution as they tend to monitor and regulate transactions.
Cryptocurrencies are actually useful. However, it's not the cryptocurrency itself that is being useful per se. It's really the technology behind it, which is blockchain. Hence, I think what is really important that we improve in the future is not the currency itself, but more importantly, the technology behind it, which is blockchain, that could actually can be incorporated in different systems in here in the Philippines and also abroad.
So far, the usage of cryptocurrencies has broadened. This includes online shopping, paying for services, international payments, a form of investment, money transfer, and as a storage of wealth. So it is safe to say that its usage varies from paying utility bills to, at one point, being able to buy a Tesla car using cryptocurrencies.
Yung cryptocurrency talaga, napakaganda niya kasi bukod sa mababa yung fees, mabilis din yung pag-transfer niya. So any part of the world, nakapag-send ka agad.
Bitcoin first gained traction in the Philippines in 2017, when its price rose from around $1,000 to over $19,000.
Sa totoo, na-interest ako kasi napapaikot ko doon yung pere. Ganyan. So, bali pa ako mag-i-invest lang ako. Then, naglalaro, pang having fun na rin, pero kumikita ka. Ganyan.
The growth of the cryptocurrency market in the Philippines in recent years has increased the possibility for an even greater variety of choices in finance, attracting people in the Philippines and giving them a new way to invest. And along with the creation of Binance Exchange, is the increase of cryptocurrency usage in the Philippines.
Super easy ma-influence lahat ng tao. Like, pwede mong sabihin sa kaklase o kaibigan mo na, uy, kumikita akong ganyan, ganito lang kadali kumita, easy money ito. Hindi na nila inaaral, hindi na nila tinitignan, diretso pasok sila, ganun kadali. Kasi ang iniisip nila, panalo na agad, din nila alam na pwede silang matalo dun. As in, super dali, basta masabi mo lang na easy money, pasok agad yan.
In a 2022 report by Finder, in the Philippines, Bitcoin is the most popular coin to own with 36%, followed by Ethereum, 23%, Dogecoin, 20%, Cardano, 20%, and others making up 32%.
And according to another study conducted by FinTech News Philippines, cryptocurrency transactions had seen a five-fold increase in the country from 2019 to 2020. Not to mention, an NFT game called Axie Infinity quickly rose to fame in early 2021 in the middle of a pandemic.
Cryptocurrencies have been proven to be viable investment options for some people. And we've also seen big companies get involved in crypto, and they treated it as a serious investment. You can see Elon Musk of Tesla and also Michael Saylor of MicroStrategy, you know, buying millions worth of Bitcoin. So some are even considering it as digital gold. So and most big banks nowadays actually and recently also include crypto in their investment portfolio and use it as a hedge against inflation.
Meanwhile, with the rise of cryptocurrency usage in the Philippines, the Banco Central ng Pilipinas released a regulation on January 19, 2017 surrounding virtual currencies, which includes cryptocurrency. It is called the BSP Circular Number 944, also known as Circular. With that said, local companies have integrated cryptocurrencies in their transactions. Two of the popular companies are Maya and Coins.ph. They give the users the ability to trade digital assets directly on their application, which gives the users direct access to cryptocurrencies. Moreover, Union Bank has also released a system that can help the users trade cryptocurrencies for fiat money.
Ngayon, sa state ng cryptocurrency sa Pilipinas, super accessible na siya. Like sa ano, yung BNB, bibigla ng BNB, pwedeng GCash payment. And since nga dun sa nangyaring Axie Wave or yung halos lahat ng tao sa Pilipinas naging aware sa cryptocurrency, mas pinadali na yung pag-access mo ng crypto. Like, cash in ka lang sa GCash, bayad ka, may crypto ka na. Ganun lang kadali yung access mo, pwede ka nang bumili agad. Like, wala na kong kailangang process na kailangan pang gawin. Bibili ka lang talaga, or pag gusto mo ibenta, ibibenta mo. Nasa yun na yung decision na yun kung anong gagawin mo dun sa crypto mo.
In terms of cryptocurrency ownership, out of 26 countries, the Philippines is the 12th country with the highest cryptocurrency ownership.
They are accessible, generally speaking. Like people of all ages, they actually can create an account. It also helps because since they are less regulated, they don't have to confirm with the different regulatory bodies, which is also a con because there's a lot of reports that the accounts has been hacked. Or there's also reports where accounts are not really registered with a real person. So those are the current problems with it.
In the early 2021, an NFT game called Axie Infinity quickly rose to fame in the middle of a pandemic where most people were practicing social distancing and staying at home. It has also started popping up on different social media sites such as Facebook.
Yung Axie, ano siya eh, parang siya nga yung father of crypto na nag-inspire sa lahat ng, halos sa lahat ng players ng Philippines ma, ano, sa crypto. Though, hindi ako nag-Axie, pero yun yung talaga yung lagi kong reference na dahil sa Axie, naging nagkaroon ng inspiration magkaroon ng ganito. Ganun. Malaking impact yung Axie.
In Axie Infinity, you buy Axie Infinity creatures called Axies and fight with other players in order to gain Smooth Love Potion or SLP. SLP is a cryptocurrency that you can then collect and sell for real money. This makes Axie Infinity a play-to-earn NFT game.
Meron siyang ano, syempre merong ups and downs talaga, hindi mo maiiwasan yun. Pero importante sa akin ay hindi ka masyado magpapadala sa ano, sa stress. Kung kumita ka man, magpasalamat ka na lang. Kung merong nawala sa'yo, kung nalugi ka, eh, matututo ka na lang doon. Sa kapag tagal, yung mga pagkakamali mo is mas magiging wise ka.
Because of its play-to-earn mechanic, Philippines quickly became the number one country in terms of daily participation in Axie Infinity, representing 40.53% of the total player base of the game.
Yung Axie kasi, naano yan eh, nabalita eh. Usually dun sa mga crypto community, ang galawan kasi dun, kunyari, piso lang to ngayon, since sa KMJS yung Axie, in just a day, naging 20 pesos yung bilian, meaning pumatok. So, it's in a sense na, since sa KMJS siya, nalaman ng nationwide, yung Axie, wala talaga nakakalam yan, ni isang crypto, sabihin mo sa kaibigan mo, din nila alam yun. Pero yung Axie, kahit din nila alam na crypto pala yun, pinasok agad nila na easy money siya. Kasi yung Axie talaga yung siya yung nag-spearhead ng passion sa mga Pilipino mag-try ng crypto.
In a statement by the Axie Infinity co-founder Alexander Leonard Larson, it has been mentioned that 1 million daily players of Axie Infinity had never used a crypto application before.
Dati yung unang bili ko kasi, hindi talaga kilala yan eh. Kung sino lang yung nag-crypto, ayun lang yung may kakilala. Alam yan, yung Axie.
Yeah. Axie Infinity, when it started, it really skyrocketed, right? Everyone was talking about it, like, you know, even tricycle drivers, wherever you go, like malls, everyone was playing, everyone wants to be a scholar, or everyone wants to start to play. And for the first 6 months, I would say, or for the first, you know, less than a year, it's really been good for a lot of people. However, afterwards, you know, we have what we call fear of missing out, and a lot of people have jumped in, and they didn't realize how risky it is because they were just focusing on the return aspect. So, in a way, if I look back, and actually I know a lot of people who've made money, but I would say there are more people who actually lost money in Axie Infinity.
Kaya ang effect nito sa Philippines is pang nag-skyrock siya. Diba na dyan si Kasoho pa nga isang bata kasi nakabili ng bahay?
Ayun din, madami rin nag-quit ng trabaho nila para maglaro ng Axie Infinity full-time.
As we've seen also in the pandemic, many Filipino players or investors have earned more from playing Axie than what they earned from their previous jobs or their current jobs. Actually, as you know, the jobs here in the Philippines is the minimum wage is very low. So, it has a general impact that it gave many opportunities to those people that are earning less. But it also impacted other Filipinos and many others lost money in it too. So, I guess one good thing that Axie made is just brought attention to blockchain and cryptocurrency. So it increases more adaptation and it increases interest in the crypto.
Sa Axie, sugal din naman yun kasi pumasok ka ng 20, out ka ng 10. Di mo naman alam kung kailan bababa yung presyo ng Axie bukas or tataas yung Axie bukas. So, madami naging sugalero, pero madami din ako nakilalang yumaman, tiba-tiba, kumita ng marami. And marami din naging money conscious, marami din naging crypto trader.
Axie Infinity has introduced the concept of cryptocurrency to many Filipinos, even the unaware.
Yung mga scholars kasi,
In a way, very good siya sa mga tao kasi hindi mo na kailangan maglabas talaga ng ano, ng malaking pera. Kailangan mo lang i-sacrifice yung oras mo, yung mga hinahabol mo na kota, saka yung tiwala. Kasi sa ano, hindi naman kasi lahat talaga ng mga scholars is nagkaroon din ang pagkakataon na yung iba naloko din, hindi sila nabayaran.
In the Philippines, AXE Infinity scholars are people who are sponsored by players or organizations to play AXE Infinity, earn cryptocurrencies, and share earnings. The sponsor gives the scholar with 3 axes and pays the scholar's monthly membership cost under this agreement. In exchange, the scholar participates in the game and earns SLP, which is divided between the scholar and the sponsor.
Yung mga scholars, hindi na nga nila kailangan, ano? Hindi na nila kailangan maglabas ng pera kasi for sure, the majority of ng mga scholars, hindi talaga nila afford. Saka nung time na nag-peak yung laro is hindi ganun ka-affordable bumili ng isang team. Saka ano talaga, ang hirap mag-desisyon kung ano ba talaga ang pinaka-sulit na bilhin doon. Tapos kung tatanungin naman is yung other end naman, which is yung mga managers, kung paano nila natutulungan tong mga scholars kasi sila yung may pera. Mas nagkakaroon to sila ng income kasi meron silang capital. Ang kulang na lang nila is yung mga scholars, which is parang sila yung mga ano nila, parang empleyado. So in a way, parang naging medyo parang business din kasi dating sa mga scholars.
But despite the benefits Filipino AXE Infinity players have gained throughout the game, it has left several Filipino gamers at the disadvantageous side. Many gamers were drawn to the game because it allowed them to earn cryptocurrency. However, 14 months later, most Filipino gamers are angry and anxious, and in some cases, hundreds of dollars down. The downfall of AXE Infinity SLP value, like any cryptocurrency, can be influenced by a wide range of factors, and both technical and fundamental analysis can be useful tools for understanding market trends and making informed investment decisions. In terms of technical analysis, traders may use indicators such as moving averages, relative strength index, and volume to identify short-term trends and patterns in the price of SLP. However, it is important to note that cryptocurrency prices can be highly volatile and are influenced by many factors beyond technical analysis, such as regulatory changes, market news, and the behavior of market participants, which are all parts of fundamental analysis. This means that the value of SLP may be influenced by factors such as the growth of the play-to-earn industry, user adoption of AXE Infinity, and the popularity of the game in the Philippines and other countries. For example, if user adoption of AXE Infinity decreases, or the play-to-earn industry experiences a downturn, this could lead to a decrease in demand for SLP, which would cause its value to fall.
May crypto game ako nalaro na tiba-tiba talaga ako, and may crypto game din naman ako nalaro na sobrang daming talo. So, pero may naiambag siya sa akin. For example, dun sa crypto na laro ko, napundar ko yung laptop na ginagamit ko ngayon. Which is nakapag-help siya sa akin academically and sa lahat ng bagay. Kasi isipin mo na may achievement ako na nakabili yung sarili kong laptop dahil lang sa crypto and nagagamit ko sa programming, sa daily lives ko. Bilang isang IT, need na need mo yung laptop eh, yung bread and butter mo sa buhay.
Despite the benefits one can gain from engaging in cryptocurrency, it also comes with risks. Some of the main problems of cryptocurrencies are 1. Cryptocurrencies are extremely volatile. 2. There is no recourse for digital asset recovery. And 3. Cryptocurrencies are used in the black market without proper regulations.
Usually, yung mga negative na nangyari lang naman during sa cryptocurrency journey ko is yung times na madami akong talo tsaka yung times na parang waliktad yung mundo mo or parang alam mo yung feeling na bigla mo na naisip na ay wala nang balikan to, ay talo ka na, ay wala ka na magagawa.
Siyempre nakaka-stress, tapos yung anxiety kasi ano eh, minsan yung nilagay ko na pera, di baka kinabukasan wala na pala.
Kahit sino naman tanongin yung nag-crypto, ang main problem talaga ay yung stress. Kasi ang stress comes from the things that you have not been able to calculate. Eh. Kunwari, yung risk. You're not even realizing that you're overspending, pero nali-liquidate ka lang naman. When we say liquidate, ayun yung parang ini-invest natin into a certain project or token, tapos akala mo pataas na, kaya bumili ka, pero ang way pala, pababa. So, yung nalulos mong money doon, ayun yung tinatawag na liquidated amount. Ayun, because really, the stress is ano eh, stress is varies from the person's experience eh, and encounter sa crypto.
May mga downfall rin kasi nangyayari sa cryptocurrency. Kahit yung maglalaro ka lang, may sa totoo hindi ko siya maintindihan kung paano siya tumaas, paano siya buhaba eh. Ayun yung ano ko. So bale, ang risk, kailangan mo talaga muna matuto.
Kasi nga early pa yung crypto, madaming taong nag-iisip na scam siya. Which is dati din, inisip ko, scam siya 5 years ago. Pero ngayon, nakakita ko talaga yung benefits niya. Pero yung problems din talaga kasi dati nag-convert ako from Ethereum to Philippine Peso. Tapos yung kausap ko, yung magsasend ng Philippine Peso sa GCash, muntikan niya na atangayin yung pera ko. Yun talaga, madami kasing scammer.
Super dami ng risk, lalo na pagbaguhan ka kasi meron, kasi yung crypto is para siyang super mysterious network na pag nag-send ka sa isang tao, wala nang balikan yun kasi di mo rin kilala yung masasendan mo. So, yung pinaka-risk mo dito is pag hindi ka marunong kung saan mo lang sinesend yung pera mo, walang refund kasi kung mas-scam ka man or mali yung masendan mo, wala kang hahabulin, walang police, walang banko. Kumbaga pa nag-send ka ng 100 sa di mo kilala, wala na talaga yun. Yun yung pinaka-risk mo. Dapat mayroon kang knowledge sa crypto.
May rate kasi yan eh. Bumababa ang crypto. Bumababa yung mga cryptocurrency. Tapos bigla na lang siya tataas. Hindi natin alam kung kailan tataas or bababa. So, paano pag nag-invest ka na mataas na siya? Tapos bigla siyang bumaba. Ayun yung pinaka-problem.
Pag yung FOMO, F-O-M-O, or also called as fear of missing out. Ito yung feeling na, for example, sa Axie nga, di ba, kunyari narinig mo yun sa kaibigan mo na, uy, kumikita ko dito sa Axie ng 3K per day, 2K per day. Siyempre, mapo-FOMO ka na, dapat ako din na kumikita din ako. So, ikaw, para mapapasubo ka bigla, like, invest, pasok doon, paano pag pasok ka ng pasok, matatalo ka din pala in the dulo. Like, kunyari, pumasok ka sa Axie ng at 20 pesos, bilihan noon, tapos, nakapag-cash out ka, 10 piso na lang, edi 50% off ka agad yung losses mo.
In addition, yung mga FUD na tinatawag nila, FUD as in FUD, it's resulting to a panic. If people are panic selling, market goes down and it actually fluctuates.
The risks also become higher for those that do not understand how cryptocurrency works. Cryptocurrency itself is not a scam, but as the demand for cryptocurrencies rises, so does the number of scams orchestrated by perpetrators who take advantage on those potential investors or traders with limited knowledge in this field.
I actually have 5 tips just for the general public. So yeah, number one, so do your research. So this is very important. So especially for Filipinos, yeah, educate yourself about the cryptocurrency, especially if there's a crypto that you want to invest in. When it comes to investing also, you need to diversify. So as I've said, don't put all your money in crypto. So yeah, spread your investments, you know, across multiple projects or investment in general. So yeah, this reduces your risk. And number three is keep your investment secure. So this is where the scam and the frauds happens actually. So always use a hardware wallet if you can, and then also save your passwords, key phrases, seed phrases. So just keep your passwords to yourself. And number four is be wary of scams. So yeah, do not click links from unknown sources. So that's one thing also. So yeah, and the number five is stay up to date. Always keep track of the news. And it's also important to remember that investing in crypto is a high risk, high reward activity. So yeah, as I've said before, you can make a lot of money here, but you can also lose a lot of money. So this might sound cliche, but only invest what you can afford to lose. So never ever invest your money that you will need or you'll use for other expenses. So crypto is here, you know, crypto's been here for a while. Actually, I was late, if you're gonna say, because it was way back 2011. I got in 2016. So I mean, crypto is here and it's here to stay. So, you know, if you don't want to get left behind, I suggest you take time to learn about it, you know, just, you know, do some, I mean, basic research, and I promise you, you'll not regret it.
Maraming useful na resources online, pero itatakal ko lang yung crypto groups, kasi may mga crypto groups sa FB page na nag-offer ng mentoring sa pag nanonood ng crypto, like kailangan mo aralan yung charts or kailangan mo aralan yung pasok. So ang masasabi ko lang is very useful siya kung gusto mo talagang aralin, pero pricey kung gusto mo magpa-mentor dun sa mga taong may knowledge na talaga sa crypto. Kung aralin mo, siguro medyo matagal-tagal din, pero matututunan mo din. Kaso nga lang, along the way, marami kang matatalo.
Basic learning about cryptocurrency, watch YouTube, read blogs, diba? Sign up to Binance, play around using your extra cash. So, you can read a lot about cryptocurrencies, but I believe that's for basic. If you want to go deeper, you need to participate in a very, very niche communities who are really doing cryptocurrencies. So may level yung ano, yung quality of resources that you can get.
To reduce the risks associated with cryptocurrencies, some laws are enacted in different parts of the world. For the Philippines, only a regulation can be found in Circular No. 944 by Banco Central ng Pilipinas.
BSP Circular 944 actually is simply an issuance pertaining to cryptocurrency exchanges in relation to money laundering, because criminals, okay, or these people that are trying to launder money, dirty money here in the Philippines, can use cryptocurrency as a means to do so. So BSP circular pertains to money laundering. They are not actually regulating cryptocurrency. They're just regulating the exchange. So if a person, a foreign national, tries to transfer one Bitcoin, that's roughly 1,000,000 pesos, okay, here in the Philippines, they can simply do so through this virtual currency exchange. And BSP circular tries to regulate the conversion of this cryptocurrency into Philippine peso or other currency here in the Philippines, because it is a means to money launder dirty money here in the Philippines. It is implemented through virtual currency exchanges here in the Philippines. You have coins.ph, for example, coins.ph. It is a Philippine company. So BSP comes in, BSP Circular 944 comes in to regulate this coins.ph, telling them that if there are transactions, like say for example 500,000 and above, you should comply with the Anti-Money Laundering Act. You should know your customer, you should know who is depositing, who is withdrawing, in order to avoid, like I said, money laundering. Because money laundering is simply transferring dirty money and making it legal. So that's the purpose of this BSP Circular 944.
Despite the posed risks in engaging in cryptocurrency, the potential of cryptocurrency for technological advancements in the Philippines is high.
There's a portion of the economy of the Philippines who will be moved by the crypto, especially in the finance sector. It can create new jobs, new type of jobs, new opportunities for people who doesn't have opportunity from the previous setup ng society. But again, if you will look at the Philippines, we are heavily a agriculture-based country. I would say hindi siya ganun kalaki na impact. Otherwise, people will able to produce a very, very, very good use cases for the Philippines to adopt the cryptocurrency, which is, I believe, some of people are also building things right now to make this happen. So, but for finance sector, yes, meron. For our biggest sector, like agricultural, construction, very small pa. Technology adoption using crypto, malaki. As you can see, as you can witness with the Axie, biglang natutong mag-cellphone, di ba? They became knowledgeable agad with crypto, di ba? Actually, it took me years before I understand how crypto works, but nung dumating yung Axie, biglang dumami yung expert with the crypto. So it only says that it can accelerate, okay, the technology advancement.
The future of cryptocurrency in the Philippines is cloudy. With only a regulation, the involvement of the government will be one of the things that would change the way cryptocurrencies are used.
Actually, we are moving towards digital economy already. If you notice the incoming generations, they are into digital economy. How do you purchase goods? You usually go to Lazada or Shopee. Those are digital stores that you can purchase. You can pay through e-wallets, GCash, PayMaya. So that's into digital economy. Cryptocurrency will complement our digital economy. So instead of using Philippine currency, using the banks, because the banks hold this currency, we can use cryptocurrency. And cryptocurrency kasi, these are decentralized. These are not controlled by the Banco Central. This is not controlled by any banks, okay, financial institution. No, these are controlled by the users. So if ever we try to regulate cryptocurrency, we try to legalize cryptocurrency as a virtual currency here in the Philippines, say legal tender, it will complement our digital economy. As to political, I don't see our lawmakers pushing for this. Okay, there is no institution like Binance, like for example in the Philippines, to lobby the politicians to make a law. Ganun ang politics. There should be a lobbyist in Congress para mag-enact sila ng batas. I don't see lobbyists trying to convince our lawmakers to enact laws relating to cryptocurrency. They are busy with any other things like yung mga pinag-aabala nila, constitutional revisions. Dun sila busy. They are not into cryptocurrency actually when it comes to our political arena.
Crypto actually could provide more financial inclusion to Filipinos by providing access to financial service and investment opportunities that are actually not available through traditional banking here in the Philippines. For example, one can easily make an account through a crypto exchange, for example, Binance, and it can easily trade crypto in just a few minutes. So technically speaking, it is much easier to get into crypto than traditional stocks. When you open a stock trading account, they have a lot more restrictions. You need to submit official IDs, you know, and it just doesn't happen in a few minutes. You have to wait for days. So when it comes to that, actually, it provides more accessibility. And it could also help in the financial stabilities of Filipinos. And in crypto in general, there's also a lot of job opportunities here. So that actually doesn't require a college degree. So there are actually a lot of remote jobs. There are moderator jobs, chatter jobs, shillers, where the pay is actually significantly better than the minimum wage here in the Philippines. And these jobs can provide or help Filipinos with their financial stability in general. Yeah. So the impacts of crypto when it comes to financial stability are still actually uncertain right now, but it could provide more financial inclusion and opportunities for Filipinos. Personally, for me, the future of cryptocurrency in the Philippines is quite optimistic. So with more people becoming interested and adapting it, but it is still relatively new and volatile, so that still requires caution and understanding. And also there are more people and companies getting involved in the Philippines. So as we move forward, there are more players on the field, so it provides more accessibility. So yeah, and also we can't deny that crypto is a kind of type of an investment, and companies want also to be involved in that. So yeah, it's new and it's innovative, and companies want to be part of that. And yeah, but of course also the future of crypto is highly dependent on how the government regulates it. So there's always the thing about the regulation, because as I've said, it's a lot of money, it's a big money. So currently the Philippines is actually good when it comes to crypto. So we don't have much regulation unlike other countries in the US. However, as I've said before, as we've seen in the US and other countries, it's also possible that the government may impose stricter regulations or restrictions on crypto in general. As you know, because there's the thing about scams, the fraud and everything. So yeah, overall actually, crypto in the Philippines is uncertain as of now, but personally it's optimistic for me. The more adaptation, the more knowledge about crypto or blockchain in general, that's good. And yeah, it's just that investors should always be careful when it comes to any developments in the government regulations. And you know, I hope that the government will provide support in crypto also.
With cryptocurrency, you can have multiple crypto projects or you can have your own coin. In economic perspective, you could see this as a source of income, or at the same time, it's a source of a way where we funnel our money through a different system. However, there's also a lot of questions that can arise from that. Say, for example, essentially it's evading the regulatory body, so it's heavily been used, again, as what I've said, is for the fraudsters or with illegal activities. So instead of going through this proper or regulated markets like the banks that can track this, it goes below. So that's not being tracked, and a lot of illegal activities can actually be attributed to cryptocurrency. One example to that is, not in a Philippine setting, but we can see that, say, for example, with Russia, when it invaded the Ukraine. So one way it evaded sanctions is actually to cryptocurrency. So it has been largely trading through cryptocurrency to buy food and to buy the necessities that it needs. So in a Philippine setting, that can also be used. Actually, there's a lot of talks during the election where cryptocurrency was used to funnel money to these campaigns that was not regulated by COMELEC at that time. So those are the things.
I would say first, hindi pa tayo totally integrated. Okay, as you can see, kung meron kayong makakausap about putting regulation sa crypto as a backfire for Philippines, mahaba pa yung usapan about it. And hindi pa siya totally na-accept ng BSP, ng SEC. But I would say if Philippines will be totally integrated, there will be a lot of opportunity kasi the monetary is global, number one. And then at the same time, it will open up a new value for Philippines. Let's say, for example, the crypto is originated here and then it opens up into the global. So imagine the value of that token or the crypto that will happen. So it will give a big impact to the Philippines. So I would say may perang papasok. Yun lang yung pinaka-gist nun.
There's two arguments for it. One is on the better light or on the positive note that they could see. You know, there's a lot of innovation that can come up with the cryptocurrency. And indeed, that is the case. You know, we have seen a lot of innovation, a lot of great minds in this field. However, they're still being overshadowed by these illegal activities that's been going on in the industry. And at the same time, there's also a lot of skepticism, criticism. And for as long as it's still not being regulated, it's still going as it is right now. Like there's no rules and regulations and they don't have to be accountable for anything, it's still largely an unsafe asset. And at the same time, for the Philippine economy, it as of the moment, it doesn't really contribute that much to the GDP, at least in terms of percentage. I would say it's still below 1% of the GDP that it contributes to the Philippines. So at least for the foreseeable future, its effects are negligible as of this moment.
Sana sa future, mas madaming tao talaga yung magkatrabaho. And ayun din, with nga PayMaya tsaka sa GCash na merong GCrypto na ngayon, panigurado mas madaming tao yung may expose and magkakatrabaho talaga sa blockchain and cryptocurrency.
Marami pa rin siyang may hikayat ng mga bata or tao. Hindi mawawala yun. Kasi doon na yung hanap buhay na ibang tao. So, bali, iisipin sa Filipino mindset nga. So, bali, iisipin ng iba. Eh, kaya naman pala kumita nito sa ganito lang. O, dito, try rin niya. Mm-hmm. Yun. Dami namang gaya-gaya dito sa Pinas eh.
Feel ko nga, ayun, makaka-adapt din tayo. Slowly, dito sa crypto na to. Di naman siya pwedeng, Di siya pwedeng pilitin kasi maraming hindi makasabay.
Hindi ako masyadong looking forward na sa cryptocurrency sa Pilipinas since lalo ngayon yung unang example ko yung Axie parang less than piso na lang yung interest ng tao parang well nagbenta ka ng crypto nagbenta ka ng NFT parang ay parang Axie lang yan diba talo ko sa Axie hindi ko na bibilhin yan parang ganun na hindi mo siya tatatangkaligan pero kung may gagawin naman silang way or move na parang game changing syempre nag-evolve naman yung modern technology na to the point na may spark nila ulit yung interest ng tao sa crypto. Go tayo dyan.
If magkakaroon ulit ako ng chance or pagbibigyan ako ni Lord, feeling ko, tatry ko ulit mag-invest. Like, mga dalawang best investment ulit. Tatry ko lang. Wala naman kasing... I mean, mukha wala naman pag nag-try. Pero okay lang. Take ko na yung risk yun. If alam ko talagang tataas siya or hindi.
Yung plans ko talaga is, for the future, kung mas matututo ako with regards cryptocurrency, baka mag-invest more ako. And depende din, kasi gusto ko muna i-observe yung market bago ako maglagay pa ba ng money regards cryptocurrency. And make a living out of it. Yun talaga yung plano ko kasi since nasa NFTs ako, gusto ko sana if 100% yung career ko nasa NFTs na and nasa blockchain.
Kunyari, nagtatrabaho ka, tapos nag-retire ka sa trabaho mo para na mag-crypto. So, tingin ko malaking big no yun. Pero kung yung invest more naman, siguro advisable ko mag-invest more if may steady cash flow ka, like may extra money ka pang crypto or pang sugal or pang lagay. Pero kung main income mo yung ilalagay mo doon, never mong gagawin yun kasi parang pag natalo ka, edi wala na lahat. So, invest pag may extra. Never invest pag yung mismong pera mo.
The dawn of cryptocurrency here in the Philippines has been a quick occurrence. From the initial interest on the rise of the price of Bitcoin, to the introduction of Axie Infinity in the country. Without any thorough laws, we still do not know how cryptocurrencies will be used. While the effects are seen in the financial side and how cryptocurrencies are now used, more laws and regulations would be created. The potential of cryptocurrency is still barely reached, especially in the Philippines. And finding a way to utilize it well would certainly affect the Filipinos.